You don't know the power of the dark side.
Broadcasting live from 38 Studios in Providence, this is the Go Ask Mickey podcast, helping you with the tips, tricks, and the tools needed to save you time and money on your next Disney vacation. If you have any questions, comments, or suggestions, send them to goaskmickey@gmail.com.
Hey, what's up, everybody, and welcome to episode number 9 of the Go Ask Mickey podcast. My name's Jerry from goaskmickey.com, and on this week we are discussing the ins and outs of scheduling your ADR or advanced dining reservations. Joining me in the studio today is Fast Eddie, the producer engineer extraordinaire. If you have any questions you want answered on the show, please send them on over to goaskmickey@gmail.com. You're listening to the Go Ask Mickey podcast, voted best Disney planning podcast past 2 years, is not us. That is somebody else. I don't know who it is. It's somebody, though. Definitely not us. So whoever that is, hey, good job. On this week, we are discussing the ins and outs of scheduling your ADRs. And I just wanted to start off by saying that I saw on the internet that Southwest came out with a 60,000 point Rapid Rewards credit card from Chase. And I've never seen those points that high. I've seen 50,000. I've seen 25,000. I've seen 40,000. I've never really seen 60,000. They might have had it. I have just never seen it. So 60,000 points is a lot of points, especially in a family of four or however many people you have. So I would suggest, you know, it's up to you. It's a credit card, you know. But I would suggest if you're traveling to Disney a lot, I would definitely get something like this because you can add up those points real quickly. And you get a lot of free flights from that. So definitely try to check that card out. I believe it's a signature card. They have three different cards. One's a business, one's a premier, and one's a signature. They all have 60,000 points. They two of them get a $100 annual fee, and one of them is a $69 annual fee. They do get, I believe it's 6,000 points on your anniversary, so you have to have it open for a year before you get those 6,000 points added. You cannot have a credit card from them within the past 2 years. So you have to be clear 24 months before you reapply for this one. Points don't expire unless you close the account, and they don't expire for 2 years after you close it. So 2 years before, you can't have one. You close it, 2 years after, you lose those points. Other than that, I think it's a great card. Definitely, I would advise people who are traveling to Disney a lot to get it. Free baggage. Your bags fly for free. There is no first class, so it's fend for yourself. You gotta scream, kick, and claw your way through a seat. So it's a great plan. I definitely would suggest it. What we usually do is you throw the trip. If you have a trip already planned, throw the trip on that credit card. Usually it's worth $2,000. You gotta spend $2,000 within the first 3 months. So if you have a trip already planned, throw that on there. You spend those $2,000 within the first 3 months, and you get the 60,000 points. Quick and easy. You pay off that credit card, you pay off the trip, you get your points, you get a free flight out of it. It's a win-win, baby. So definitely look into that. Other than that, we will be right back with some Disney news from around the world right after this.
This portion of the show is being brought to you by Whatever We Have in Stock Are Us, your one-stop place to shop for whatever we happen to have lying around at the time.
All right, this is what's going on around the world in Walt Disney World. There is rumored of new transportation in and out of Magic Kingdom. Back in 2016, Disney filed permits with the South Florida Water Management District to redevelop World Drive. For those unfamiliar with World Drive, it is a major artery of Walt Disney World's transportation and is the road that brings guests past Hollywood Studios and the Boardwalk Resort, right up, straight up through to Magic Kingdom Transportation and Ticket Center. Anyways, according to the permits filed, Walt Disney World will be adding a flyover ramp, which will route traffic directly from World Drive so that guests heading for the resort area hotels can bypass the Magic Kingdom parking plaza altogether. In the opposite direction, another newly constructed flyover ramp will allow traffic heading from Contemporary Resort side of the World Drive to continue on World Drive beyond the Magic Kingdom Plaza. So directly en route to the Boardwalk Resort and Hollywood Studios. In addition, Disney will be widening World Drive as well as both sides of the street, transforming the two-lane sections into three lanes and the three-lane sections into four lanes. It is also heavily rumored, though not confirmed yet, that the parking lot toll booths at the front of Magic Kingdom will be also replaced during the extensive road work. So you'll still have that toll booths thing, but you'll have a wider road, and it's just a way to go around the bypass to the resorts. So that'll help with congestion as far as getting to Magic Kingdom, because some mornings it's insane. That's going on this week. Also, we have apparently Disney is reportedly closing FastPass Plus loopholes. The current FastPass system has presented ways for guests to take advantage of the existing infrastructure in the park. And one loophole allows guests to use the park tickets and magic bands of guests that have not yet entered the park on any given day. This loophole, dubbed the park validation, allows guests to reserve more than three advanced booking fast passes by utilizing multiple IDs. So you can take your fast pass, put it on you. You have three fast passes on you. Then you can also take somebody else's or buy one. And as you enter the park, you can now go to a kiosk and put three fast passes on that magic band and use those. So you're creating a whole, they call them dummy fast passes. Beginning on June 7th, Disney will attempt to close these loopholes by requiring all tickets used at a fast pass plus entry point to be validated as a ticket that was used to enter the park that day. A similar enforcement is currently in place at Disneyland with the FastPass paper kiosks. It is unknown at this time if any penalties will be assessed for guests attempting to continue using these loopholes. I've heard rumors of them closing the MDE, which is my Disney Experience app, and shutting that down so you can't use that, you can't schedule FastPasses. So that's pretty serious. So I don't know if it's going to happen. I mean, you'd have to be, you know, caught a bunch of times. The guys over at Backside of Magic have always talked about dummy bands and how to get around the loopholes. They explain it a lot better than, I can. But basically, they're shutting that down because apparently there's some, you know, crazy people getting extra fast passes that shouldn't. So that's a no-no in Disney's eyes. So apparently, yeah, just don't get caught on doing your fast passes, and you'll be okay. We will be right back after this with the ins and outs of scheduling your annual dining reservations, or ADRs, right after this.
Bud Light presents Real Men of Genius.
Real Men of Genius.
Today we salute you, Mr. Hair Gel Overgeller.
Mr. Hair Gel Overgeller.
Less ambitious men stop with two-in-one shampoo, but you put in countless hours, tireless dedication, and a 5-gallon drum of industrial adhesive.
Sticky goo.
Like a lacquered hedgehog or oily porcupine, what woman wouldn't want to run her fingers through your razor-sharp stalagmites of hair?
Or is it stalactites?
Wind, water, stray bullets, even repeated hammer blows. Nothing can muss your immovable mane.
I got a hair helmet.
So crack open an ice-cold Bud Light, oh master of the moose. And while you're at it, crack open another bucket of goo.
Mr. Hair Gel over there.
Bud Light Beer, Anheuser-Busch, St. Louis, Missouri.
All right, welcome back. On this week's main topic, we are discussing the ins and outs of the Advanced Dining Reservation System, or the ADR for short. These are extremely popular and cause the most stress of people planning their vacations, other than fast passes. The dining reservations are like, you know, people get ulcers over this stuff. So there are hundreds of opportunities all over Disney World property to get dining reservations for. Now, any guest who is staying on property is allowed 180 days prior to arrival a chance to make ADRs, or advanced dining reservation. Now, that means if you're coming on, you know, whatever date, 180 days, they have calendars out there, they have apps out there, you can find those all over the place that count down what day is for what. And if you find those, that you can go to plug in your arrival date, and it'll tell you 180 days is on this such and such date. Now, on that day, you're allowed to make your annual dining reservations. Now, your annual dining reservation is that day plus 10 days after that. So you can schedule a restaurant for 10 days into your vacation. So you're allowed 10 days into a vacation. Say you're saying 14 days. You can still only do up to 10 days as far as scheduling a dining reservation. So your best bet is going to be on the 9th and 10th day of your vacation, if you're staying that long, to schedule those hard-to-get restaurants. The Ohana's, the Be Our Guest, the Cinderella Royal Table. Those are the harder ones to get. You should try to book those further out into your vacation than at the beginning. Some people don't have that choice, and you're going to have to settle for whatever it is. But I would suggest that you plug those in later on in your vacation than in the beginning. Because that 180 days plus 10, you're allowed 190 days to schedule annual dining reservations. So, but that's only if you're staying on site. You have to stay on site to do that. Now, once you do that, once you get into that system, you can go on that 180-day and you can schedule your reservations at 6 o'clock in the morning, Eastern time, on your Disney MDE, your app, My Disney Experience app. So you can go on that app, you can go online, and you can schedule your restaurant reservations from that. And that will, as long as you get a confirmation number and have everything set up in your MDE, including your credit card and all that, because a lot of these reservations, they require a credit card. So make sure that's all set up prior to the 180 days, because at 180 days, at 601, you don't want to be going, oops, I forgot to put my credit card number in. Let me stop and do that. Now somebody else just got your reservation. So this is where it gets crazy. So now at 6 o'clock in the morning, you want to plug in what you need, and you want to go to the hardest reservations you want first. So go to those days that you're going to get those Ohanas and the Be Our Guest and all those reservations that you're going to find harder to get than at like Sci-Fi or wherever you want to eat after. So plug those in first. Get those squared away as soon as possible. Now, if you can't get those, or if you can't get access to being online, they're at 7 o'clock a.m. Eastern Standard Time on your 180th day. You're allowed to call. That's 1-407 WDW Dine, D-I-N-E. So at 7 a.m. on that 180 day, you're allowed to call and schedule those reservations from that. Now, once you get on, you know, the phone call and talk to a person, they will be able to tell you what is available, what is not available. And I would do the same thing with them. Go to the harder to get restaurants first. Then you can go and work your way around the rest of the vacation time. So that is a few steps in figuring out how to use this system. Now, you also have an option of using, I believe it's the Open Table. Now, this Open Table, I believe you can download that in the App Store. But you could also go to their website, Open Table. And there's only certain restaurants that are available on this Open Table for getting restaurant reservations for. And that's at Disney Springs. You're allowed the Boathouse, Bongo's Cuban Cafe, Crossroads at House of Blues, Fulton's Crab House, Morimoto Asia, Paradiso 37, and Wranglin Road Irish Pub and Restaurant. So those at Disney Springs, you can go to Open Table and get a reservation through there if you can't get it on your MDE, your app. You can also go, the Disney resorts also have the Big River Grill and Brewing Works at Boardwalk, Bull and Bear at the Waldorf Astoria, I believe it's called Kappa, I don't know, Four Seasons, that's at the Four Seasons, and Garden Grove at the Swan, and Molino, New York Trattoria, that's at Walt Disney Swan, La Luce at the Hilton, Bonnet Creek, Ravello is Four Seasons, Shula's, which is at the Dolphin, and Todd English's Blue Zoo, which is also at the Dolphin. Now, great thing about using Open Table is that you just sign up with them and you'll receive points when you're booking a reservation. And you can go to their website or their app, which is all free, and you'll get an email confirmation, and that'll be your receipt as far as the party size and the time you booked. So once you accrue enough points on this Open Table, you can then redeem those points for gift cards and use those. So kind of paying yourself on getting those reservations. So that's pretty much it on figuring out how to schedule and reserve reservations through or using the ADR through my Disney experience or through the cast members over the phone at 407-WTW-DINE. Other than that, it's just a lot of waiting and waiting and waiting, and you got to be patient when you're trying to schedule. You know, you can't get those reservations that you want, but if you wait long enough or if you just keep people cancel reservations all the time, you know, your best bet is to look at that 45-30 day window before your trip, because other people will cancel their vacations altogether and they will lose all those reservations that they've had, you know, within the payment plan. You know, things happen. So 45 days prior to arrival, you have to make a payment, or 30 days prior to arrival, you have to have a payment done, depending on your package. So check those. I would check often, you know, as much as possible. You know, check it on your app at work, whatever you're doing, and you'd be surprised what people cancel and when. Even the day before, you might find a reservation people can't make it. You're in the parks and you really wanted to go to Be Our Guest that next night. You didn't get that reservation. 24 hours, people have to cancel within 24 hours. It might be, you know, a couple people can't make that reservation the next day. Things happen and they cancel that reservation. Or you can try to separate the amount of people in your party as far as table-wise. I mean, two people you can't separate, but, you know, a party of six or a party of eight, depending on the large crowds or a large party, you can separate into tables of fives or sixes, depending on how big you are, and to be booked at the same time. So you might have a better chance of getting those. I think the larger the dinner reservation, as far as people-wise, the hotter it is to get that reservation. So you might want to split it and ask when you get there to be sit, you know, together or sit near each other. So there are ways around it, but definitely patience is the biggest part of it. Other than that, that is it on the ADRs, the ins and outs. If you have any questions on any of this, please send them over to goaskmickey@gmail.com. And we will be right back to wrap up the show in 2 minutes, 2 seconds.
You quit it?
What?
Trying to swim here. What, the ocean big enough for you or something like that?
Huh?
You got a problem, buddy? Huh? Huh? Do you? Want a piece of me? Yeah. Ooh, I'm scared now.
All right, I'd like to thank you all for downloading today's episode. That is it for this week. If you could, follow us on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, over on YouTube. We're on YouTube now. And check us out on iTunes. If you could, leave us a review over there. And if you could text this show to two of your Disney friends and help us spread the word and support the show. And until next time, Disney Nation, rock on!
Head on over to GoAskMickey.com or check us out on Facebook or leave us a review on iTunes.